Hello and welcome back to this, the fourth video in my Garmin Pilot series. And in this video, we're going to talk about IFR flight planning. And you'll see I've got the map today set up with an IFR chart. So let's get started. So the first thing we want to talk about with IFR flight planning is that firstly, we're not going to start by using the map. Simply because, certainly in Europe at least, trying to hack together an IFR routing that will get accepted just by picking waypoints on the map is very unlikely to work, or at least be extremely frustrating. So we're going to use some of the tools within Garmin Pilot to get a route generated for us that hopefully will be accepted. Now, to make that work, it's really important that we've got our aircraft set up with the appropriate performance data. So if we just have a look at one of my aircraft here, and we go and have a look at the performance, we can see that we've got all the data for how the aircraft will perform during cruise, climb, and descent. Service ceiling, etc., which will help the routing tools pick an appropriate route for our aircraft. And when we file the route, that will be giving the correct information to ATC. So let's go ahead and get started. So as I said, we won't be starting on the map page. We are going to start using the trip planner. Okay, so as we said, we'll start in trip planning. And this is a trip that I've already done, so let's just get rid of that one. And we will create a new trip here using the add trip button. So the first thing we need to get correct, obviously, pilot in command is me. And because we're going to be doing an IFR flight, we need to say, so I'm based in Europe, so we're going to be using the Eurocontrol IFR filing service. So now the flight rules have changed to IFR, so we're in the right starting point. The aircraft is, for the purposes of this exercise, going to be Golf Sierra Uniform Echo Oscar. Not using a call sign, we'll be using the aircraft registration. And the departure is going to be from Oxford, which is Echo Golf Tango Kilo. And let's try and make it for a trip that I'm actually going to fly. So we'll say it will be on the 21st of June. We'll be ready to go at 9 Zulu. And our destination is Echo Delta Whiskey India, which is Wilhelmshaven in Germany. We won't do anything with the alternate now. So let's have a look. The rest of this we can now kind of leave as it is, because what we're going to do is use the auto router. So if I press auto route, we get another page of prompts. So we just confirm departure airport, departure time is what we want, destination aerodrome. This has all been carried over from the form we just did. We're not going to enter a manual IFR route. We're going to let it find it for us. So we're going to optimize it. Yes, shortest time would be best. We're not going to go above flight level 100 because we don't have oxygen on board. Flight rules, we prefer all IFR. No countries we want to avoid. Prefer standard routes for UK and Ireland, so if anybody flying in the UK, I would encourage you to leave that turned on. There's a special document called the standard route document in the UK, that will get incorporated into the planning. Generally discourage directs. Yes, we'd much rather it took us along preferred routes. And open water, not too worried about. There's not nothing that we can't cope with a raft and jackets, I think, between us and Germany. So let's hit auto route. And I'll let you see what this starts to do. It does take a little while to do this, so I'll probably pause the video and we'll come back when it's actually completed. But let's just start watching, and you'll get an idea what it's doing in the background. At the moment, it's obviously pulling in a lot of information about the airway network. There we go. And as we see, it's already started to find some routes. So it's picked a route and then it's looking for any restrictions on that route which would prevent us from flying it. And it's going to do this probably for a little while now. I will start my stopwatch and I'll let you know how long it takes, but I'll stop the video and we'll come back to it because you probably don't want to watch it click through all of this. Okay, so the routing has just completed. It was actually only another minute that it ran for after I stopped recording, and it was probably running for about a minute at the beginning. So it probably took a couple of minutes to pull that routing in. So let's have a look. So we've got a standard instrument departure to IFR arrival route. So that looks good for us, and it's the shortest, so I think we will pick that one. So we press next. And there we go, we actually get a full description of the route. We don't need to note all of that down. We can just do confirm. And you can see now it's just going off and validating this route. And there we go, we've got a validated route. Here we can see the nav log. We can do our mass and balance now as well, because this can all feed through into the briefing document. So it's me in, David in, Faith in, put our baggage on the back seats because that's always best from a mass and balance perspective. And we'll put the sort of aircraft equipment in the back. Fuel 106 litres, so full tanks, and we're all inside limits, so that's great. It's all synced up with Garmin Pilot Cloud. We can see the briefcase icon over here on the right. That's showing that everything that we need to fly the route is already on my iPad. If you had a warning there, you see a yellow warning symbol, and you can then download all the information so that you know once you've got a green tick in the briefcase, we know that we've got everything that we need to fly. And then what we can do, which is really quite cool, is if we click on the brief, what this has done is this pulls an enormous pack of briefing information for the flight. So it collects everything together. Expected weather. Looks like we're going to have a very nice smooth flight. So we've got a complete briefing document. I won't go all the way through it, but you can see it's pulled NOTAMs. There's a plog in there. There's the weather information in there. NOTAMs for the airports. Here we go. It's even pulled the UK LAR services. I don't know why we need those for a IFR flight. But there we go, we've got a complete pack of briefing information. So that is great. So we then have the option, obviously, to file. So if we wanted to actually file the flight plan, we would actually say file. We won't do that right this second. And then here with this activate button, there we go. By pressing activate, we've actually transferred that into our flight plan. And we can then start to use that in flight. And then obviously we could, you know, do our normal overlays. Probably wouldn't want to be flying this route right now. Looks like it's quite a bit of weather going across the North Sea. Let's turn the radar off. We could have a look at NOTAMs, you know, all the usual things that I've shown you how to do before with Garmin Pilot. There we go. So that's how we do an IFR route. A little bit less to it actually than creating a VFR route, mainly because we're letting the system do all of the work for us. NOTAMs we've got, apart from the arrival and destination, a little bit less to be concerned about, because air traffic will be taking care of those for us. There we go. I hope you found that video useful. Some of you that were more observant or fly IFR in Europe more regularly already may have noticed the similarities between the briefing document, and let's go back to that again, between the briefing document that we see here and the one generated by the AutoRouter tool. I'll put a link to AutoRouter in the description in case you've not used that tool, but actually Garmin have licensed use of the AutoRouter tool. You can still use both, whichever you prefer really, but it's just good to know what's powering this in the back end. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you found that useful. If you have any questions, please pop them in the comments below. I always try and respond to any comments and clarify anything that needs clarifying. Thanks very much for watching.